is John Finnemore's Souvenir Programme.
Hello? Who's there?
It's me, Mother.
Oh, hello.
You didn't call me.
Oh, I've been busy.
So I called you.
Yes.
So?
Yes, all well here. The garden's doing nicely.
No. What did you think? You did get the book, didn't you? I had them send you two copies.
Yes. I got it.
And did you read it?
Mm-hmm.
And so, what did you think of it?
Well, I don't really know, Sigmund.
But you must know, Mommy.
Well, a lot of it was very technical, too hard for me to follow.
But not all of it.
No, not all of it. Some parts were very clear.
And you liked it?
It doesn't matter what I think. What did your clever neurologist friends think?
I don't care about them. I care about you.
Yes. Yes, that came across.
I mean, never mind the science. Did it feel true to you?
Well, it wasn't quite what I expected.
Really?
No, well, the interpretation of dreams. I thought it would be, you dream of a blue cat, you look it up. Oh, it means you'll come into some money.
What? No, it's nothing like that.
No, I know that now. Siggy, these things you say that everybody wants.
Yes?
Are they things that you want?
Well, the whole point is they are things everybody wants subconsciously. Me, you...
No. No. Not me.
No, but in the subconscious.
No! Not anywhere. Very important you understand that. Not at all. Not me. No.
No, Mother, I must say I'm very surprised at your reaction.
Yes, yes. Well, so now we have both been surprised. anyway, that's the doorbell, Ziggy. I must go. Goodbye.
Goodbye, Mother. I love you.
I like you too.
Hardy, I fear I am at my rope's end.
No, my lord. 'Tis but a glancing wound.
No, I think not. The chaplain.
You there! Pass the word to Lord Nelson's chaplain! Lightly now!
Oh, but he will be too late.
No, no!
Take care of Lady Hamilton.
Of course.
And?
Yes?
Kismet, Hardy.
What the hell?
What? Sorry, did you mean a real full-on...
What did you do that for?
You told me to.
What?
You said, kiss me, Hardy.
Kismet. I said, Kismet, Hardy.
Oh, God.
I mean, why on earth did you think I wanted you to kiss me?
I don't know. Maybe you thought a little kiss would cheer you up.
From dying?
Well, I don't know. I was simply obeying orders, sir.
I quite clearly said kismet.
With respect, sir, you really swallowed the tea.
Well, I'm sorry if my diction wasn't up to scratch as I lay dying. I am in the middle of a naval battle. Well,
no, I'm just saying it's not my fault if I misheard. Also, what is kismet?
Kismet. It's the Persian word for fate.
Right. Well, with respect, Your Lordship, that's a really weird word just to suddenly say. Without any context.
Context? The battle is context. Me dying is context. I was saying it's fate. Fate has caught up with me.
Yes, sir. Either of those sentences I'd have understood. But you didn't say that. You just said one word and you chose to say it in Persian. So, you know, forgive me for interpreting it as the common English expression it sounds exactly like.
What are you suggesting, Hardy?
I'm suggesting, sir, that you wanted a kiss. And that's fine, no judgment about that from me. I just think it's a bit mean of you to then go and construct this elaborate get-out for yourself that makes me look like an idiot.
Well, look, let's just pretend it never happened. Let's say my last words were, take care of Lady Hamilton.
Aye, aye, sir, and I'm sure none of these 30 or 40 grinning sailors surrounding us will ever breathe a word.
Oh, damn it. Well, may as well be hung for a sheep as a lamb. Come here.
So, you'd like to find out about your past lives?
That's right, yeah. You see, I've always had the sense that I...
Yes, you're right.
...that I've passed this way before, I was going to say.
Yes, I know, and you have. Reincarnation is real.
Well, because my theory is...
No, I'm telling you, it is.
Oh, right.
So, shall we begin?
I am ready.
Good. So, which lives do you want to know about?
Oh, is there not a ritual or a trance?
No,
or...
I can just tell you. It just saves time. So you've lived 7,472 lives as a human. Which one interests you?
Well, I've always felt an affinity to Cleopatra.
Okay, so you want to know who you were when she was alive.
Well, I always thought I might
You
have
were four been... people.
What?
When Cleopatra the VII was born, you were a peasant in China. You died aged 26 when Cleopatra was 2. Then you were born in India and died the same day. Then you were born in Persia and died the same day. And then you were born in what is now Argentina and lived until you were 16 when you died in childbirth.
Oh, come on.
What?
Well, it's a bit depressing, isn't it?
I mean, I'm not really the person to take it up with.
All right. Who was I in Tudor times?
Oh, loads of people.
Okay. Who was I when Elizabeth I was crowned?
A peasant.
And when she died?
A peasant.
Same peasant?
Oh, God, no. This is like 8 peasants later.
Well, when was I something other than a peasant?
Let's see. Well, as I say, you've been loads of babies, briefly. And let's see. Peasant, peasant, slave, peasant, serf.
Ooh, what's a serf?
Cross between a slave and a peasant.
Right.
Okay, here we go. Mid-16th century Flanders.
Yes?
You were a villein.
Ooh, what's that?
It's a really posh peasant.
Doesn't seem like a big difference.
You thought it was at the time. You thought you were great.
Okay, have I ever been anybody important or interesting?
I'm sure to your various families and loved ones.
You know what I mean, have I?
No. Sorry. Why, are you someone interesting or important now?
Well, no.
There you are, then.
Right. Can I just ask?
Yeah.
Is this real? Can you really do this?
Oh, yes. Yes, there's a lot of charlatans about who'll tell you you were Joan of Arc or whoever, but this is absolutely genuine.
Right, okay. These charlatans.
Yes.
Do you happen to have a number for any of them?
So, how have you been doing?
Oh, well, how long has it been?
Oh, at least a couple of years.
Well, then, the big news is I've had another baby.
Oh, congratulations.
Thank you. Yeah, another boy. Nate. Doing very well.
So that's what, your second?
Third.
Oh, gosh.
You must come round and meet him.
Yeah. Maybe.
Maybe.
Well, it's just, will I understand him if I haven't seen the first two? Yeah, because I never really did meet them, did I? So will I get this new one now, or will it not really make much sense on its own?
I mean, they're all really good kids.
Oh, no, I'm sure. Everyone says they're must meet. But, you know, there's just so many really good families I'm trying to keep up with at the moment. I just wonder if I've left it a bit late to start following yours.
No, I don't. It's too late.
Well, how long ago did it start?
Do you mean, how old is my oldest child?
If you like.
Yeah, she's 8.
Oh, okay, you see, that is quite a lot to catch up on. The next one's probably, what, 5?
6.
Right, and sure, yeah, I could just jump straight in with this new one, but then I'd miss out on all the complicated backstory.
Right, you know, children aren't the same as TV shows.
Aren't they, though? How are your kids dealing with the new baby?
Well, Helen's really great with him because she got that envy stuff out of the way when Will arrived, but Will's always been a bit in Helen's shadow. Yes, I can hear what... Yeah, you're right. Fine, don't come.
Thanks. Tell you what, I'll wait till they're adults and then I'll binge meet them then.
I came as fast as I could, dear leader. I pray that I am not too late.
You are the last.
Oh, great leader, I scourge myself for my miserable failure.
Get it, sit.
Your mercy is as great as...
Sit. Now, I have called this special session of the Presidium of North Korea because I have written a poem.
Glorious news.
Yes,
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.